Hi guys, okay, so in today's video, we're going to go and learn, okay, how to sketch a quadratic graph. So sketching a quadratic graph isn't that hard because you have seen this, okay, throughout your secondary school, okay. So to sketch this quadratic graph, okay, we need to follow a few steps, okay. So if you just follow these few steps, you can easily obtain the final output. So first, okay, of course, we need to go and pay attention to the value of A to know whether is it a happy graph or a sad graph. So here, the value of A is bigger than 0, i.e. I'm going to get a happy graph. That's number one. Number two, it is good that we go and see, okay, whether our graph is going to cut the x-axis or not. For this purpose, okay, we can just go and calculate the value of B square minus 4AC. Okay, so here, our value of B is going to be 2. So 2 square minus 4, A is 1, C is 3. So I'm just going to ignore the 1. So this is going to be 4 minus 12, so going to be negative 8, which is less than 0, i.e. no root, so it's not going to cut the x-axis. So we don't have to go and find the x-intercept. Number 3, we can find what is our y-intercept. So y-intercept, when x equal to 0, so that is going to give me value of 3, 4. It would be good if we go and find what is our extremum point. Extremum point in our case, either minimum or maximum. So here, since this is a happy graph, we're going to have minimum point. How do we find minimum point? Well, completing the square. So I know many of you don't like completing the square, but then there's no other way. Somehow you have to use your completing the square in order to get this. So fx equal to, so if you don't remember your completing the square, just follow what I'm doing. So every time, please make sure your A is 1. If your A is not 1, then you have to factorize. How do we tackle this kind of problem? I will show you in the next example. So here, I just copy this first. Then plus, my B is 2, positive 2. So normally, it will be B over 2. Then we square. Okay, so here, our B is positive 2. Positive 2 over 2 is 1. So 1 square. So you plus, then you minus. Okay, so when you minus, it's like U equivalent to doing nothing. Okay, then this one plus 3, just follow. So now I'm going to combine certain thing. What is a certain thing? This guy and this guy here. Okay, so I'm going to put that into this bracket. So you see this is 1, right? Positive 1. So here I will put plus 1. If here say you have minus 1, then you put minus 1. Okay. So if you just expand this, you will get these three terms. That is how we do completing the square. The rest, I shall just leave it here. So this guy will become minus 1 plus 3, so it's going to be plus 2. So that is our completing the square form. From here, we can easily tell what is our minimum point. So the minimum point here, very simple. Okay, for some of you, okay, who already know how to find the minimum point, I'm very sure you can just read out and say it is going to be negative 1, 2. For those people who are not sure, okay, very simple. All you have to do, just cover here. Okay, cover here. You see whatever that remains. That will be the minimum value. So we can say minimum value equal to 2. When, since you cover this part, right? So you say x plus 1 equal to 0. That will give you x equal to negative 1. So when you want to say the minimum point, you can easily say your x value is negative 1. Negative 1, the minimum value is 2. There you go. That's how I get my minimum point. So I hope you can follow up until the fourth part. Okay. So we already got almost all the ingredients that we need in order to draw the graph. Okay. So I think we can just straight away go and draw our graph. Okay, so where do I try to fit in? This is the problem. We have a very limited space. I want to make sure this still remains. So maybe, okay, I'll just get rid of this. Okay, try to fit it in this region. Okay, so here, okay. So if you just look here, okay, graph should would be only for this range of x, okay, meaning you say this is the domain. So I'll just go and stick that in negative 2 and 1. Okay, so we look one by one. So this is your happy graph. So that's a shape. Okay, nothing. Y, sorry, this is your x-intercept. So it doesn't cut your x-axis. Y-intercept is 3. So I can go and put my 3 there. Minimum point, negative 1, 2. So your 2 is here. This is your negative 1. So your minimum point will be here. So I just have to go and fit in this guy. It'd be good if we go and tell what is our value of y when x is negative 2 and 1. Okay, so we know where to start and end the graph. So if I just go and put negative 2 in there, so that is going to be 4 minus 4, 0. So going to be positive 3. So I'll be here. I'm going to leave it open because it's not included. When I go and put 1, it's going to be 1 plus 2, 3, 3. So we're going to be 6, so I'll be somewhere here. This one I'm going to put it down because it's included. Okay, so your graph, we can go and connect now. So it's going to be something like this. I will go up here, it will cut at 3, and you end up like that. So I can proceed and tell, okay, what is the domain and range. So the domain normally, okay, this guy is not there for decoration. This is going to be my domain. Okay, and the range we can tell easily. Okay, the lowest value to the highest value. So the lowest value here, okay, as you can see, is going to be your 2. The highest value is going to be 6. So I can just go and say the range 2 to 6. This is going to be my domain. Okay, hope that solves the mystery. Thank you.